James David Wiggins, born August the 16th, 1985, weighing in a whopping 15 pounds, grew up here in Guildford and went to school just around the corner. Welcome to George Abbott School, James's secondary school. Everyone remembers starting secondary school. Baggy blazers, oversized backpacks, they were just the standard. Everyone at school was just trying to fit in and be cool. And do you know what being cool was? Hanging out with me.
A badge of honour at school or sixth form is to be one of the first people with a set of wheels, and James succeeded in that, as while he was here, he was actually in a wheelchair. Now, we've got some very rare footage of Nick and James at George Abbott School that we'd like to show you.
I want to go on the big one.
Well, maybe you should finish your candy floss first.
But I want to go on it now.
It'll blow away.
I am willing to take that risk.
So, after school, James had to go out into the world and find a job. Sainsbury's, I was pretty successful here, worked here for years. James's brother also had a job here, quite successful. James applied, didn't get in.
He also tried to get a job here, but was unfortunately unsuccessful as well.
And after months of rejection, James finally got his dream job. Well done, mate.
It was here in Foxglove Gardens that James's hockey career began, after he watched a little film you might know.
Remember this one, buddy? The Mighty Ducks? We used to watch it after school, and then we'd come out here on these very streets, be inspired by the plays and the Fulton Reed slap shots. And we'd come out, probably should have been doing our homework, but we had better things to do.
And it didn't stop here. James took his hockey career to higher and higher heights. From the streets to the ice pad, James eventually started playing hockey here at the Guildford Spectrum. So he, sorry, we've got a highlight coming through right now.
James Wig Wam Bam Wiggins skates as graceful as a ballerina, but hits as hard as a New Year's Day hangover. The big guy is in white. He's moving across the ice. Look at him go. And oh, what a hit on the play. Crunch that lunch, big man. Let's take another look. Ice, ice, baby, hit me one more time. Get that poor man a stretcher. Does he even know where he is right now? Someone call Dancing on Ice and tell them this guy can cha-cha charge.
One thing that James is known for is his really powerful slap shot. And I've been playing with him now for about 18 years, and he's always mocked me for my capabilities of being able to hit the puck. So this is just a little bit of revenge. Step aside.
Oh, I'm Wiggy. I've got a really hard time. Oh, Nick's jumping.
Hey, mate. Look, we know you're very protective of all the ladies in your life. And that's one thing we respect about you. So I just want to say I'm really sorry for this. She loved it.
Anyone want a tissue?
Oh. Don't need it.
No. Okay.
Don't need it.
Okay.
So here we are outside the mighty Martin & Co. of Aldershot, James's place of work. He's been working here for about 9 years, and we've always wondered why this location here in Aldershot.
Yeah, James is a very good guy, so he's regular customer, and he's very good. So he's basically comes like kind of every day, all the time.
He's gonna see this, right? He's all right. Yeah, he's pretty good when he's here, not on holiday.
All right, we won't show this bit.
No.
What, just between us, what's he really like?
Well, sometimes, you know, the stress does get to him with the business, and I have to sort of take the lead. sometimes if, you know, we've had a difficult month, I've found him crying in the toilets.
Average.
Lazy.
An absolute
noisy eating.
He's always in the toilet. Always. And he's in there so long that we actually have to spray afterwards.
Grease everywhere from the chicken. You know, he's in the loo, so we have to get in some activities now and again. You know, on his phone, just generally not doing much, to be fair.
I'd probably say second to last.
And how many bosses have you had?
10.
Hey mate, it's me again. I just wanted to say sorry for the thing with your sister. That wasn't very cool. She's family. Although we are all best friends and we do share everything, so we thought this would be okay. Sorry. You're a lucky man though. Very lucky.
Good.
Tonight's going to be great. If that was anything to be going by.
Hey mate, do you recognise this place? For anyone that doesn't know, there is a story about James which focuses on friendship, bravery and courage. But I think the best person to tell this story would be his colleague, Richard. Over to you, Rich.
Had a call or a text from James one morning saying, oh, you're going to need to take me, I've got to get a cab into work, you're going to need to take me to collect my car this morning. I thought, right, okay. He said, I did a valuation last night and I parked right outside. It's like a mechanics, like an industrial sort of unit. The car got locked in. When he came out of the valuation, there was like a barrier there or something. So we turned up to collect his car about 9:15 in the morning. And we arrive, it's a very long, narrow track leading to this unit. As we got there, there's these big gates that say private property, keep out, doors will be locked at night. So why the hell he parked there, I don't know, but his car was already turned round facing the right way to come out. Because it was very narrow, I had to drive right in front of this building. James jumped out of the car, got into his as I was turning my car around behind where his was positioned. And as I was doing this, three fairly angry looking pikeys came out of the unit, and one of them was having a conversation with James through the window of his car, and he looked pretty upset.
Who the hell do you think you are? Get out now, get in here, I'm gonna have you coming on my lounge, you Porsche, eh? You wanna have some of me, so tell you what, I'm in the right mood to have you, you little shit. Get out the car now.
At that point, the guy, I think he tried to rip his wing mirror off or started banging the car, shouting at him. So James bravely sped off up the lane. completely out of sight. And they then turned around and started coming towards me, where I was sat in my car. This guy was probably angrier, got as angry as I'd ever seen anyone, as quickly as I'd ever seen anyone, and was sort of shouting at me. So James has now gone all the way up the lane. I can't see him. It's completely gone. The guy's swearing, saying, you saw that, he tried to run me over, and then said, I'm going to phone the police, and proceeded to lock the gates and lock me in this compound. But when the guy did eventually come out, he calmed down, and I sort of talked to him, said, look, I just came to help him collect his car. And they opened the gates and let me out. Light hostage taking / kidnapping was not what I had on the agenda that morning.
As many of you know, one of James's true passions is his cars, and in particular his Porsches. His new Porsche, he loves it more than anything, and he would never do anything to hurt it. And so, mate, I just want to say, I'm so sorry. I'm so, so sorry.
Later, bitches!
Hey,
That's Nick Perry driving your Porsche in the rain down a track. He's being very careful though. To be fair to him, he's being very careful. Lads. Hi everyone, me, John, best man, senior. Behind me, what's happening? This is day one of the stag do. Wiggy's fine, but Lewis, his stepbrother, is being questioned by the police.
Let's do that.
Get right back to where we started from. Love is good.
I'm gonna cry though. I just wanna go to bed. It's too much. It really is.
Beautiful. Yeah, me again. Sorry about the sister, I've said that. And sorry about your wife. We thought there was one person that you wouldn't really mind, but maybe you will. Couldn't help ourselves. Oh, Nick. Ooh. Oh, no. Absolute filth.
Oh,
good night. Women of a certain age, eh? You can shake an apple off an apple tree. Shake a shake of sugar, but you'll never shake me. No siree, stick like glue, stick because I'm stuck on you.
Ring any bells?
Let me explain. This is the story which we like to refer to as Gluehead. It was the night before the last day of school and James's mum Marion kindly offered to give James a haircut. Fair enough, you've got to look sharp on the last day. Unfortunately, she put the wrong setting on the clippers and accidentally cut a chunk straight out of his hair. Nice one, Marion. Don't think it was the look you were going for. Most parents would probably just let their child have the last day off. Not Marion. She had a plan. To glue... Yes. To glue James's hair back onto his head and send him in like that. Now, James came into school, tried to tell us all that some glue just randomly fell on his head. We didn't believe him. And the nickname Gluehead stuck, quite literally.
Well, how can I just say, with Wiggy, known this lad for years, knew him when he was 6 stone. But as a person, lovely person, always lead from the front, always first to the bar, and always the last one out, and that all mean the bar. Downside of it, when we go away, nobody wants a room with him. I'll tell you what, the noise coming from that lad is something else. He must practice.
Hello, so being the best men, we figured that, you know, we'd better go check out the honeymoon suite. J- just make sure it's all ship shape and ready to go for you guys. So let's take a look inside.
Well, we'll check it out. So apparently only 20% of couples actually consummate their marriage on the wedding night. So we just want to say, mate, we hope you're one of those 20%. Don't think about us in your bed tonight when you're with Nat. Just don't think about that. Don't think about that, Mr. Floppy, Mr. Wiggins, and have a great night. Go for it, lad. You can do it.
Thank you very much for listening to us.
Thank you very much.
We've been the best men.
We have.
And we hope you appreciate our speech. It's been quite funny, I think.
Has it been funny?
I think it's been funny. Have a great evening. Have lots of drinks. Buy these two lots of drinks. Nat and James.
He's over there. He's having a singing.
And, yeah. Peace out.
And we love you all.
We love you.
Bye-bye.
You got it?